Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another collab video. This time, this video is hosted by Barrett Pastor. If you haven't checked out her YouTube channel, I highly encourage you to do so. She is hilarious. She puts out fabulous WW content with a little bit of a twist, and I love her channel. She's fairly new to the YouTube market, and it's nice to be able to promote such a fabulous newer channel. So make sure that you check her channel out down in the description box. Also, all of the other channels participating in this collab will be down in the description box as well. So make sure that you take a moment and check them out as well. So today's video is a fun one. Not my typical meal prep or recipe video. This one is about getting to know my channel. So I'm going to be answering for you some of the most common questions that I get as far as my YouTube channel goes. Some of these questions are things I get all the time. Other ones of these are some random information facts that I feel that you should know about my channel. So if you want to hear all about what Jen's WW journey has to offer, all you have to do, stay tuned. So I've got my list here, and let me answer all of your most frequently asked questions. So here's my list, and let's get started. Question number one, how old are you? How tall are you? What is your start and what is your goal weight? So I am 43 years old. I am 5'9". I do not have a goal weight at this time. I am waiting to see how I feel. I don't necessarily agree with WW's goal weight charts. So I wanna make sure that when I feel good about my body and the weight that I'm at, that is what I'm going to consider my goal weight. So I am not going by the WW chart, and I am not one that wants to share necessarily my starting weight. I feel that that is very personal. Just know that I get 33 smart points a day, so I have a higher starting weight than those of you that are a lot closer to your goal weight. So that's what I'm gonna say about that. So question number two, what part of your body do you feel most self-conscious about? Oh gosh, this is a good one. Most of my body I'm self-conscious about, honestly, but the one part of my body that bothers me the most is my back. So I do have quite a bit of back fat, and I know that you can't spot target losing weight, you can't spot target working out, but yes, my back fat is the area of my body that I'm most self-conscious about. I try to wear a bra that has a wider band so that it helps constrict a little bit of that area. And it's just something that I'm going to have to live with until I get a little bit closer to my goal weight. And I'm hoping that that kind of goes down a little bit as I do get a little bit closer to my goal weight. Question number three. I want to lose 25 pounds. If you've lost that much, what first changed in your appearance? So I have lost roughly 20 pounds, so I have not hit the 25 pound mark yet, but what I'm noticing most in my appearance is just my overall body frame is smaller. I've actually had people start to notice. I had a couple girls at work make a comment that it looks like I've lost weight, so that's always nice, and I just feel like my clothes fit a little bit better, and just overall, my body size feels a lot smaller, which is great considering that I've only lost 20 pounds. So the next question is, what is my tip to drink more water? That's funny. Here's what I have sitting next to me. So I'm actually a huge water drinker. I typically drink the big, you know, 32 ounce Starbucks cups of water. I drink usually 3 to 4 of those while I'm at work. Well, to give you my biggest tip, if you're not a water drinker, is to add some flavoring. Use the water enhancers, whether they're the liquid form or the powder form, that helps you get in your water. But don't go too crazy, because a lot of those water enhancers do have calories, anywhere from 5 to 10 calories. So if you're drinking 2, 4, 6 of those packets or sets of drops a day, it can add up to 1 to 2 to 3 smart points. So my trick is I will either add water enhancer to, but if I'm using the liquid form, I will add it to 2 glasses a day. If I'm using the powder form, I take 1 of my water enhancer packets and I divide that up between 2 of my big water cups, and that's it. All of the rest of the water that I drink throughout the day is unflavored. That way I'm not overdoing those water enhancers. You can also add things such as lemon, lime, oranges, cucumbers, frozen berries. You can add all of those things to your water as well, which definitely helps make water a little bit more appealing. But I enjoy water. I typically drink it out of a bottle. I don't know what it is about it, but I like to drink water out of a bottle a little bit more than I do. The next question is, do you do YouTube full time? And if not, what do you do? So No, I do not do YouTube full time. I wish. That would be an awesome goal down the road. But no, I do YouTube part-time in my spare time. I actually work full-time at a university here in town, and I am a human resource manager. So it is definitely a very busy, oftentimes stressful job. I don't have a lot of time at work to do YouTube or social media things. I know a lot of you have been asking for a day in the life at work. It's just a little hard for me to film, but I'm working on it. But yes, in fact, I work outside of the home as an HR manager, and yes, I would love to do YouTube sometime down the road full time. So the next question, what state do you live in? So I live in Washington State. I live in Spokane, which is about 5 hours east of Seattle, Washington. Most people know Seattle, but don't know Spokane. I've lived here most of my life. I was actually born in North Dakota, which a lot of you ask me where my accent comes from. I don't think I have an accent, but several of you have asked me, and I'm venturing to guess that comes from being born in North Dakota. However, we did move to Washington State when I was 5. I have lived in both Montana and Idaho as well, but I always seem to make it home to Washington. That's where my mom is, and I love the area that I live in. It is gorgeous. It is so great for outdoor activities. We actually live out in the country on 3 acres, so we live on the river where we can ride our four-wheeler. It's kind of my jam. I love Washington State for sure. Now I would move to relocate for a career, but so far so good we've been able to stay in Washington. So this next question is a good one. Does it upset you when people give you a thumbs down or leave a bad comment? Yes, it does. So I have preached this a couple of times on my channel already, but let's first talk about thumbs downs. So I honestly, in my opinion, have never seen a YouTube video that deserves a thumbs down. We work really, really hard on our videos. It takes a lot of time to not only film the video, but edit the video and make sure that we're even thinking up good content to share with you. So when you give us a thumbs down, yeah, it's discouraging for sure. But I also know that there are a lot of haters and trolls out there. And I know for me, I get a lot of the same numbers of thumbs down, and we can see analytics. I don't know if you guys know that, but we can see if our thumbs downs come from those that are subscribed or not subscribed. Most of mine come from those that are not subscribed, which is fine by me. I would prefer that they don't subscribe. But of course, some of them do come from subscribers, and I wish we knew why so that we could change our content or give you a little bit more of what you want if you do feel like you need to give us a thumbs down. But yeah, it's discouraging. I'm turning over a new leaf where I'm not gonna worry about it. I'm gonna put out the content that I know that you guys love. And to be honest, my thumbs up outweigh my thumbs down 1,000,000 times to 1. So that's that with the thumbs down. And as far as the negative comments, I don't allow them. I will block you, remove your comment, and you won't be able to leave them on my channel anymore. I want my channel to be a positive place. I'm here for support for you guys. I want you to support each other, and I'm not going to tolerate negative comments. So honestly, I've probably only received a handful in the whole time that I've had my channel, and I have promptly deleted those comments and blocked those people from my channel, again, just to ensure that it stays positive. So if you're one of those people that does give thumbs down or leave negative comments, don't, because we put a lot of time into our videos, and truthfully, if you don't like the content that we put out, don't watch it. The next question is, how do you give yourself a pep talk when you've had a bad day in life or with the program? So this happens to me a lot. Like I said, my job can be really stressful. There, as you know, if you follow my channel, have been plenty of weigh-ins that have not went the way that I preferred. And you know what? I'm a super positive person. I always look at the why behind the negativity. So is it something that I could control? If it is, then I try to fix that. Especially when it comes to WW, it's typically something I can control. If it's not something I can control, like Mother Nature or something at work, then I let it go. And I just focus on the positive things in my life, because to be honest, I feel extremely blessed to have my dogs, my husband, my family, and all of you. So I just focus on the positive things, and I just give myself a pep talk that it could be worse. There's, I'm sure, 1,000,000 people worse off than me. My life is not bad, and I can overcome this just like I've overcame everything else. The next question is, do you exercise? And do you do it regularly, yes or no? So at this point, no, I do not have a regular exercise regimen. It has been winter here, and I have felt zero motivation to exercise. But Spring has arrived and it is gorgeous outside right now. So now that the snow has started to melt off, I am going to be walking outside where I live. And I also do walk around a lot at work because I work in a university. I'm going to and from a lot of the different units for employee issues or to help managers with things. So I do get some exercise at work, but yes, I'm going to be implementing a lot of walking and I will be having a regular exercise routine. So of course I'm gonna take you guys along with me and I'm going to share my exercise plan with you as well. That will be in an upcoming video. I know that you can do WW strictly on food because the weight that I've lost has been strictly on food. But I know that in order to remain nice and tight and not be flabby, especially if you have a lot of weight to lose, exercise is important. So the next question, I love this. Do you ever sneak food or not count it and act like you never ate it? Duh. I think all of us do that. But what's funny about that is even though we don't track it, our body tracks it. So regardless whether we lie to ourselves or lie to our tracker, our body doesn't lie and it knows the food that we've consumed. So I have been really making a valiant effort to not lie and to honestly track my food. If I overeat, I try to track it. So then that way I can see my weeklies go down. I'm also trying, as you know, on my day that I do use my weeklies, which by the way, I use them every week on Saturday, I'm trying not to go over my daily and weekly points so that I'm not overindulging. That's one thing that I do struggle with. So by honestly tracking even my indulgences, I can see exactly the number of points that I'm using. So yes, of course I have done that. But no, I do not plan on doing that moving forward. And the last question, which is a bonus question, is what is one YouTuber that you watch outside of your niche? So I watch so many of the WW YouTubers. I love so many of them. In fact, a lot of them are in this collab and a lot of them will actually be in a collab that I am hosting towards the end of April. So make sure you stay tuned for that. But I also do watch a few people outside of my niche, so outside of the WW arena. So I do watch Amy Macedo. So she does do some What I Eat in a Days, but she does not follow WW, as well as some fashion types of things. I also watch Alex on Learning to Be Fearless. She does a lot of like fashion hauls and beauty hauls and things like that. And that's, I mean, I guess that's about it. Oh, I do watch Obese to Beast, and he is a workout fitness guy, but of course he doesn't follow WW, but you guys should check it out. He's lost over 100 pounds and yeah, he's got some great tips and tricks on his channel. So of course I watch the majority of WW, but yes, I do have a few of my favorite that are outside of my niche. So that's it guys. Thank you so much for joining me and learning a little bit more about me and my YouTube channel. I am all about WW. My channel content will never change. It is going to be WW primarily, but I know that a lot of you like to see vlogs and some other fun twists thrown in there here and there. So of course I'll be incorporating some of those videos as well. A huge thank you to Barrett for hosting this collab. Again, make sure that you check out her YouTube channel as well as all of the other channels linked down in my description box below. If you're new to my channel, welcome. If you came over from another channel, please comment and let me know what channel you came over from. And if you're one of my YouTube friends and family and you go to another channel, please let them know that I sent you. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, also the notification bell. That way you're notified every single time I upload a new video. Give this video a thumbs up. Comment below. Let me know what you thought about getting to know me. And of course, if you have any other questions that I could answer for you, please leave those down in the comments below. And of course, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.